Playbeat 4, Audiomodern's next generation AI-powered drum designer, features cutting-edge algorithms and revolutionary genre-based pattern generation, allowing for endless new drum patterns, sounds, and rhythms. In this video, I will walk you through the complete production process with Playbeat 4, from creating a drum kit to exporting and mixing your beat, and I will break down all features along the way. In this new version, three main controls play a crucial role in shaping your beats. One is the randomization modes. Choose from four modes: fully random, remix, smart, or instant. Second is the randomization scope. Decide what to randomize: pattern only, sounds only, or both pattern and sounds together. Third is the complexity level. Adjust the complexity of the beat you want to generate from subtle to extreme. These controls give you full flexibility to create unique and dynamic rhythms effortlessly. These patterns and sounds are selected completely randomly from the sample pool. This can be helpful for coming up with new ideas. Sometimes, however, you already know where you want your musical journey to go. In this case, Playbeat 4 provides you with the new genre-based randomization feature that helps you find sounds and grooves that match your vision. Activate the AI button, open the drop-down menu, and select up to three styles. Let's go with techno for now. Clicking the main randomization button will generate a new pattern each time you press it, including patterns with sounds that align with the selected genre. No two patterns are ever the same, generating an unlimited number of unique variations. Right now, we're randomizing an entire kit, but you can also randomize individual tracks. Simply select any track and press the randomize button. If you want to keep the current sounds while randomizing only the pattern, select the pattern control. This will generate a new pattern while preserving the sounds of the existing kit. If you're happy with the pattern but want to experiment with new sounds, select the sounds control. This will retain the pattern while introducing new sounds to the beat when you randomize. If you have a beat you like but want to create subtle variations, switch to the remix control. This will generate slight changes to the existing pattern while maintaining its overall feel. Another cool feature is a randomization algorithm we call Smart. Smart bases its randomization off of presets in your collection and uses these to create its variations. First off, let's head into the preset manager. Now, in order for the Smart algorithm to work, we need to select various different presets in our collection as Smart. We can do this by going through our library and clicking on the Smart icon next to whichever preset we want to mark as Smart. We can do this across all different packs and presets in your collection. All the presets that we mark as Smart then show up in the Smart folder under Presets and Packs. Selecting Smart Mode and then clicking the Random button will then engage it. Each time we hit the Random button, it will go through the presets that we've marked as Smart and come up with variations of these presets. Another mode is Instant Mode. It continuously generates new patterns as long as the Instant button is pressed. It works with all the other modes and can be especially useful for live performances. For more advanced pattern customization, you can manually adjust or randomize the values in the five individual tabs below. Each tab includes a randomization button that works alongside the complexity slider. The lower the complexity, the smaller the randomization range. Let's take a look at the panning tab. Additionally, you can manually adjust all values using your mouse to customize your beat. To reset the values of a specific tab, click the Reset button. If you want to reset all tabs at once, use the main Reset button here. In the Pitch tab, which features our real-time pitch shifting engine, we've now added scales. You can set the root note and choose a scale for the sample to be randomized. The pitch shifting range is determined by the complexity slider. If you want to have a custom pitch shifting range, you can enable this button here and enter the desired values. Then hit randomize. This control, which allows the tab to use custom values, is available in all tabs. Simply enter your desired values and press randomize. Another great generative feature is the signature infinity control. When enabled, it creates a new pattern every time the loop cycles through. You can also set the number of loops before the beat changes to a new one. Playbeat includes hundreds of sounds and patterns across various styles and genres, but you can also import your own audio files. You can drag and drop any audio file directly onto the sequencers or add a folder from your computer to browse and preview samples. To be able to control the global volumes for each one of the channels, you can jump into the mixer section. This has a volume control for each one of the 8 channels, also solo and mute controls, and panning controls. If you've made any changes here and you want to go back to the default, you can hit the reset button at the bottom right here. Below the tabs, you'll find additional controls. The first is the sample randomization control, which selects a random sample from the sample pool rather than using the genre-based algorithm mentioned earlier in this video. You can also switch back and forth within the sample pool. Next is the sample editor, where you can fine-tune your sample, apply filters, adjust the start and end points, and add crossfades. The shift control moves your steps one position to the right or left within your pattern. This control allows you to merge notes. Click repeatedly to adjust the values to 1, 2, 3, or 4 steps within the same cell. Next is the rate control, which adjusts the speed of the sequencer playback. It can be applied individually to each sequencer or to all sequencers at once if the All button is enabled. Next is the delay control, which introduces a time delay, shifting steps off grid. This is the flam control. When enabled, you can adjust each step to create the characteristic flam effect. Here is the copy and paste control. When enabled, it allows you to duplicate one section and paste it into another. Each sequencer includes options to solo or mute, and you can adjust the playback range using the range bar at the top. On the right side, you'll find 4 different controls. You can completely erase the pattern, lock the entire sequencer to prevent any randomization, swap tracks to rearrange the sequence, and copy one track's values to another. You also have the option to change each sequencer's icon for easier browsing and customization. Any changes made here will be saved along with your preset. Playbeat offers 2 pattern triggering options. It can stay synced with your DAW at all times, or you can trigger the sequencers manually using MIDI input or your keyboard. The bottom multifunctional keyboard allows you to trigger either the full beat or individual sequencers using MIDI input or a MIDI keyboard or controller. You can also trigger the individual sounds from the selected kit. Playbeat includes a remix section where you can store your own pattern variations. Simply make adjustments to your pattern and click an empty key to save it. You can store up to 24 different variations and trigger them within your project using MIDI or a keyboard. You can also click the Generate button, and Playbeat will automatically create 24 unique variations of the current pattern. This feature allows you to use it as a song mode within your projects. You can also lock specific remixes to keep them unchanged while generating new variations for the rest. Saving a preset is simple. Just click the Save button, enter a name or generate one, select your style tags, and hit Save. Style tags are important as they help train the internal AI engine, which will also begin learning from your own presets. At the top right-hand corner here is the Export button. This will allow you to export all the various stems straight out of Playbeat along with the audio, but also the MIDI data from the Pitch tab. All you need to do is just drag and drop the audio file, and you can drag and drop it straight into your DAW or onto your desktop. If you want to use the MIDI within your DAW, you can drag and drop the MIDI. This is the Preset Manager, divided into 3 sections. At the left, you'll find presets and packs, where you can view all your preset folders and expansions. You can also select your samples folder from this section. The contents of the left menu are displayed in the center, whether they are presets or samples. On the right side, you'll find all sample slots with several options. Solo and mute each slot. Randomize to pick a sample from the selected folder. Remove a sample. And lock a selected sample in place if you want to randomize others from this section. You can also use the filtering option to search for a specific preset by name or filter by genre. One of the great features of Playbeat is the introduction of packs, which are collections of presets and sounds that you can import to expand your library or export to share with other Playbeat users. These can be accessed from the Packs and Presets menu and can be viewed down the left-hand side menu. Underneath Packs, you have the ability to create your own pack, import a pack, or browse more packs via the Audiomodern website. Let's start off by importing a pack. Depending on the size of the pack, it may just take a moment to import that pack and it will appear on the left-hand side menu here. With the pack selected, you'll be able to see all the information about the pack, including the pack name, author, and description, along with its artwork, and then all the presets contained within it. As with all our apps, the pack system is fully unlocked, allowing anyone to create and customize their own packs for backup or distribution. We'll start this by clicking on the Create New Pack item here. First thing we need to do is give it a name, and then we'll give it a description as well. To finish it off, let's give it some artwork. Now we need to do is drop some presets in there that we've created. We could do this by simply dragging and dropping it into the pack. Find a place to save it on your hard drive and then click Save. This will then create a Playbeat pack, which will contain all of your presets and all of your sounds all combined. All the main settings for Playbeat can be accessed by the cog icon at the top right-hand corner of the screen. This contains all of the MIDI settings. At the top left-hand corner, you'll see all the MIDI out settings, including which track to output, the MIDI channel, the different MIDI outputs. This is all your different MIDI devices and also internal MIDI routing. This allows you to take any of the MIDI information that's generated within Playbeat on any of the 8 tracks and output it to another MIDI channel within your dub. You can enable or disable each individual track on the right-hand side here and choose which note it outputs from. By default, it's C3, but say for example you wanted to output this to another drum rack within Ableton, you could choose the note at which you want that track 1 to output to. You also have the option to lock the output settings for more accurate preset browsing when using Playbeat as a MIDI generator. Underneath this are the linear and choke group options, and below is the library location control. Choosing a new location will not only move the current library to the selected folder, but will also set it as the default location for all future audio files. And then finally, on the right-hand side here, you have all your MIDI mappings. All of the different functions within Playbeat that are able to be MIDI mapped are in this list. If you do not want to use the standard MIDI learn feature, which is up here, you can easily choose what you want by assigning a CC value or use a key from your keyboard. If you want to reset this at any point, you can click the reset button here. This concludes our Playbeat walkthrough video. We hope you enjoyed it and that it helps you get the most out of your plugin. Thanks for watching and see you soon.